having downloaded your black and white section from the website, these are some of the things you can scratch with. You could use paper clips, you could use straight edges like plastic rulers, you could use split pins, metal rulers, hairpins, anything you could get your hands on. And then don't forget to get your paper towel to catch any loose bits. So, to start with, the thing that you should probably do is pick some oil pastels that you think will look well together. But the thing you've got to remember is you've got to put a lighter colour on the bottom with a darker colour over the top. When you put the darker colour over the top, what will happen is it's not really going to mix with those lighter colours and it will disguise the lighter layer below. Don't panic, just press down nice and hard and make sure that you cover as evenly as you can. When you're doing so, my best advice would be to outline parts of the shape that you are going to colour to that standard. So with this brown that I'm doing here, what I decided to do was I went round the outside edges of where the field was, having already coloured it orange first with some oil pastel. I then used a brown colour to place over the top, the brown being darker than the orange. When you've coated as evenly around the outside edges of your image, as you can see above, you can either continue using the same colour or you can change to another darker colour. So the cloud above the wolf, I've decided to do red underneath merged with yellow, and then I used a dark blue over the top. The dark blue mixed with the orange and went fairly dark, and then with the yellow it almost went like a teal kind of green, like a really light pale ocean blue. So it all completely depends on how your pastels mix, but the rule of thumb, just always remember to try and put a dark layer on top with a lighter layer below. Once you've finished, you get rid of any crumbs using that paper towel and you rub those off your print and they land onto the towel, and then you can dispose of those so that they're not causing a mess in your house. When you are ready to start scratching using your sharpened tools, what you need to do is get yourself a hard surface. If you don't want to make damage at home and you don't want to press too hard onto a table, what I've done is I used a magazine. I then started to get my tools out ready that I was going to scratch with. So I had a cocktail stick, I had split pins, I got myself a ruler, I got myself hair clips, and I even got myself metal edges like rulers or paper clips. Get yourself ready, and then what you do is you need to start deciding on what type of mark making you're going to use to create your patterns. So you've got things to decide, like for me, because I was doing near the wolf, I decided to start trying to create different patterns and textures that I thought you could see or feel in grass. So I went with this kind of like grass blowing in the wind idea. When I did so, what I tried to make and mimic was the idea of like fire or something like that happening, which is quite cool. So it looked like the orange that was being revealed below looked like flames. I also started to use spirals and loops. So I started to spiral and squiggle these loops across in different layers so that I could give my grass different kind of textures. So I had grass texture, I had spiral textures, and then I thought I would decide by ending with lines. So I used my plastic ruler, the triangle, and I scratched away. As I was doing so, you realise that these bits are building up on the end of your scratch tool. So what you should need to do is use another sheet of paper towel, and then you can get rid of any of those little pieces and put them to one side, just like I did here. As I was working through this, it was really nice to see the orange being revealed. So when you're doing it at home, try and remember to just combine colours and play around with the idea of how colours can appear underneath each other, and they work really well together, and it's really nice and it's really fun. Thank you for watching. I hope this video tutorial has been really helpful in helping you create a Sgraffito technique on your own separate tile. Now you've done, don't forget to photograph it and send it back to yorkshiretales.co.uk.